How's it going, everyone? Welcome back. So everyone loves talking predictions, right? Let's talk Ja'Marr Chase, rookie year predictions, Cincinnati Bengals. Let's start off with some comparisons. How about Julio Jones? Rookie year, 95 targets, 59 receptions, 959 receiving yards. Now, he did only play 13 games. Julio Jones, though, stud of a player. Can you believe this? Justin Jefferson, I don't know why this seems like such a surprise. I knew he played well last season. This man dropped 1,400 receiving yards last season. Joe Burrow's ex-teammate, Justin Jefferson, the one that's not supposed to be as good as Ja'Marr Chase. Can you imagine what that could translate to? DeAndre Hopkins, 52 receptions, 882 yards, 16 games. His rookie season, 91 targets again. Different quarterbacking situation for DeAndre Hopkins. He had Michael Thomas, 121 targets, 92 receptions, 1,137 yards in his rookie season. 9 tutties, by the way. But Drew Brees, yeah, heard of him a little bit. He did have Drew Brees to work with there. All that being said, there's a lot of different things bouncing back and forth there for where Ja'Marr Chase could fall. Justin Jefferson was kind of the sole option there. Michael Thomas, you could say the same about him. DeAndre Hopkins, the quarterback he had to work with. There's a lot of different factors that factor in here for how some of these rookie campaigns do turn about. The Bengals this season are going to play Baltimore, Pittsburgh, Green Bay, and San Francisco, all of which comes out to what, 6 games? All of which were teams inside the top 10 when it comes to receiving yards allowed last season from a defensive standpoint. Some tougher matchups. On the contrary, the Bengals are going to play 4 games against teams that were on the bottom 10 in the league last season as far as receiving yards are concerned. And you know what? I mean, fact of the matter is you got 4, 6, 7. It's kind of average across the middle there for the Bengals as far as the schedule is concerned. But it's important that you think about stuff like this because you see a guy like Ja'Marr Chase going there against the Seattle Seahawks type of defense. The Bengals had a chance at a cakewalk matchup like that as far as a wide receiver is concerned. You're going to go out there, sling that football. It'll be a 35-40 type of, you know, score in that game. It's a beautiful matchup, we should say, for, 150-plus yards for Ja'Marr Chase. Those matchups matter. Especially if you reel together 3 or 4 of those against bad teams, you know, that's 500-600 yards right there in 4 games. Makes a big difference on that stat line across the season. Same could be said about playing lockdown corners. But as we know, there is far more to this than just the schedule for Ja'Marr Chase. I mean, there's chemistry. There's more chemistry. I mean, how rare is it, I should say, do we see a quarterback wide receiver tandem in college like these two go to the NFL and play together? Super rare. That's a big factor where you don't build that chemistry going into your rookie season as a wide receiver. You don't have to build that chemistry of that quarterback because it's already there. That's going to play a huge factor. You did not see that with all those guys we listed earlier. 84 receptions, 1,780 yards, 20 touchdowns in what, 14 games? With LSU the last season these two played together, those numbers are ridiculous, period. The thing is also, though, we have to remember, just like Joe Burrow did in college, just like he did last season at the Bengals, this man's going to spread that football out. This isn't a situation, a Justin Jefferson situation, where Stephon Diggs goes out the door and your number one man, well, you got Thielen as well. We got to be careful what we say there. Man, Thielen, what happened to Thielen last season? I just completely forgot about him. Maybe a Michael Thomas is a better comparison there, where you got your number one man, your number one man over there. This team's got Higgins. They got Boyd in the slot. They got Chase. 3 guys that could very well, I don't think it's even bold to say, end up with 1,000-plus receiving yards this season. Burrow is going to spread that football around. That's going to affect Ja'Marr Chase's numbers, period. I think this is a situation, what if it was Higgins, no Boyd? Boyd's not there. You just have Higgins. You have Chase. That could be a really good matchup for, you know, Ja'Marr Chase, because then you still have a guy out wide drawing the other CB's attention. It's a very good receiver that could, you know, prevent some double teams to an extent, prevent you from seeing the number one as much. But you got 3 guys. 3 guys, which means, again, it's going to help Ja'Marr Chase flourish in a big way because, again, you're going to have your attention going everywhere. You can't go out there and double Ja'Marr Chase because Joe Burrow is going to pick you apart throwing it to T. Higgins or Tyler Boyd all game. Period. That's going to affect him. There are so many factors into what happens with Ja'Marr Chase this season. It really is just, could be a complete guess. We're going to say 102 targets, which is on the higher end of the spectrum here to an extent still, even with the weapons. 64 receptions, 1,047 yards. We're going to say 7 touchdowns. I think that's being modest. There's a really high ceiling for Ja'Marr Chase. That's our predictions. Love to hear your guys' thoughts. As always, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next time.